Back on the campus of Weber State University in Ogden, Utah, we are awaiting the second game of this first round action in the West region. Syracuse has advanced to round number two with a victory over the Rainbows of Hawaii. And it is Wisconsin Day in Ogden, Utah. The Cheeseheads are here, some of them for Green Bay, Wisconsin, and some of them for the University of Wisconsin, who play this evening here in Ogden. Earlier, Syracuse advancing, the number four seed, and they await the winner of the game upcoming, the number five seeded California Golden Bears and the number 12 seeded Phoenix of Green Bay, Wisconsin. Hello, everybody. I'm Tim Ryan with Ann Myers back here at the campus of Weber State. And Jason Kidd, of course, the man everybody's talking about. There's a sellout crowd here waiting to watch this phenom from the California Golden Bears.
Well, he really is. He leads the nation in assists, 9.1, averaging over 16 points, and also leads the team in steals. So he does it all. I mean, the way he leads this ball club is the way Cal is going to go.
Well, it's a big order to stop this young man because, as you point out, he controls the floor out there. And this team that he's playing, however, has a very structured kind of a defense. Dick Bennett's Phoenix has a plan.
The plan is get back on defense, that's for sure, but they have to execute man-to-man defense strictly, and they have to keep the ball out of Jason Kidd's hands. But Gary Gresh, a sophomore who's an All-American soccer player, so he's good on his feet, has to stay up with Jason Kidd, and that's going to be a task.
That is a task and a test. Now, of course, the Golden Bears don't rely solely on Kidd. Lamon Murray's having quite a year scoring for them.
Yes, he is. He's averaging over 24 points, and he has great range. He can go inside, outside, and Eric LeDuc, the senior, strictly a defensive player, doesn't score much, is going to try and contain him.
Well, these Golden Bears with a 22-7 mark, quite a remarkable season, to consider the string of injuries they've had. They lost two probable starters early in the season, Alfred Grigsby and K.J. Roberts, and then later on, one of their valuable reserves, Randy Duck, on with a wrist injury, but still they managed to stick together, and we talked to Jason Kidd, who's clearly the leader on this team, about the unity they have now.
I think the most important thing now is we have confidence with each other. You got to be a unit to be successful in the tournament, and that's what I feel confident about right now, is that everybody is on the same page and on the same line.
Well, the starting lineups this afternoon at forwards for Wisconsin Green Bay will be Jeremy Ludvigson and Eric LeDuc. We talked about him. Gresh will be joined by John Martinez in the backcourt with Jeff Nordgaard, the center. For the Golden Bears, the forwards will be Lamon Murray, joined by Michael Stewart, a freshman from Sacramento. Kidd in the backcourt with Monty Buckley, in the center is Ryan Jameson, a junior from Los Angeles. Dick Bennett, the coach of Wisconsin Green Bay, the number 12 seed here in his 18th year of coaching in the NCAA, more than 500 victories. His team won the Mid-Continent Conference Tournament, beating Illinois Chicago in the final 61-56. He is highly regarded. Todd Bozeman, just in his second year, but what a start he had last year for the California Golden Bears. This season in the Pac-10, a 13-5 mark, good for second place. They are an at-large entry in the tournament with a record of 22-7, their most victories since back in the 59-60 season. They've won three of their last four games, despite having lost those three key players as the season has gone on. The Golden Bears control. Jason Kidd, California in white. Green Bay, Wisconsin in green.
You know, you talked about the injuries for Cal, and their bench is not very deep, but they've gone with these players all season long. They're very conditioned, the Cal Bears.
Murray missing the opening shot. And Martinez losing it off the hand of Kidd, and so the Phoenix maintain possession here in the opening seconds of play. John Martinez, a senior from Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
They're very deliberate on their offense. They look for the wide open shot.
Dixon feeding inside. Now it's kicked out for Martinez. There's a steal nicely anticipated by Michael Stewart. And Kidd trying to fire it down to Buckley. That goes out of bounds. It'll be California ball.
Cal might have the advantage as far as athletic-wise. And so in playing a team like Green Bay, Wisconsin, they have to be patient and not get too frustrated, because Green Bay, Wisconsin is going to play such fundamental basketball.
Murray called with a travel. Still scoreless, opening minute.
Obviously a pace also that the Phoenix would like to slow down and keep the score low.
Nordgaard opens the scoring.
number 33.
Jeff Nordgaard, the sophomore from Dawson, Minnesota. Hurry for Jason Kidd. Buckley inside. Jamison has it stolen away by Martinez. Three turnovers already by the Golden Bears. Martinez started a three, passes it off, and it's outside to Kresh. They can move that ball, and the lefty off the iron. Kidd back the other way. Kidd's jumper right on the three-point line. Nordgaard rebounding.
Gary Kresh, real good defense right in Jason Kidd's hand, face, but Kidd just saying, hey, I missed it. Just a little too hard. That's his first shot, just trying to feel himself out.
There's a feeling that he's going to be surprised at how difficult it is to penetrate. Nordgaard driving, Kidd rebounding. They expect to cut him off, close the lanes, penetration and passing lanes against Kidd today. That's what they want to do.
Well, their defense is so strong. There's another turnover by Cal, and you see Green Bay, Wisconsin slowing the tempo down. But Green Bay, Wisconsin, they are so tough on defense. They really help each other out. They're a team where they switch on defense and rotate.
Duke outside, the forward. Off for Kresh to Martinez. Martinez driving, good block by Jason Kidd. Nordgaard follows, and Nordgaard hits for the Phoenix. 26 victories, 6 defeats for Wisconsin Green Bay, their second NCAA tournament. And they won the Mid-Continent Conference tournament, defeating Illinois Chicago in the final.
And one of the reasons Cal is turning the ball over so much, they're just not executing. There's a nice pass down low inside.
Won't go for Jamison.
Even though Jamison misses it, Cal finally got really a good shot selection that time.
Nordgaard rebounding. Kresh driving on Buckley. And it is LeDuc.
LeDuc only averages 4 points a game. He's already halfway there.
6-0. Wisconsin Green Bay, Kidd slowing it down, setting up the play for the Golden Bears. So far, Kidd also holds the record for lowest pants in the tournament. It is early, however.
Waiting for him to come off, huh?
We have two more games to go, so that he's the leader in the clubhouse. And he's hiking them up.
Well, here's the one big key that Green Bay, Wisconsin has to do, get back on defense. And here you can see five jerseys in the picture and really the trailing of the white jerseys. So they've stopped the break of Jason Kidd in the open court.
Ludvigsen picks up the first foul.
Dick Bennett was running some great plays in practice yesterday.
Very impressive practice. This is such a disciplined team, organized, calm, and poised. They're going to be tough for anybody. Jason Kidd. Murray lets it fly off the mark. LeDuc trying for the rebound, but is taken by the Bears and then comes back to Green Bay.
This is not the kind of pace that Cal likes to be in either. They like to an up-tempo. They like to get running, get in the open floor.
Bears have Akilah Jones, one of their few substitutes available in the game, a senior from San Francisco, number 33.
That foul on Jeff Nordgaard trying to get position on Jason Kidd, and they couldn't get the ball inside.
We have a timeout on the floor, 15:57 to go, first half. Wisconsin 6-0. Dick Bennett, not exactly a household name in the college coaching ranks, except among his peers, where he is somewhat of a guru. He's highly, highly respected. Of course, his son Tony Bennett, the beneficiary of his dad's coaching, now playing with Charlotte in the NBA.
And his daughter, Kathy, also is a coach at UW-Oshkosh. She's the head women's basketball coach there.
There's a steal by Martinez on the feed from Jones. Akilah Jones copping it up. Crash to Burlowski's in the game now. Good three-point shooter, Ben Burlowski for the Phoenix, number 34. LeDuc outside, the 6'7 senior forward. Burlowski in the corner, Kidd on him.
10 seconds on the shot clock. This is the kind of offense that Green Bay likes to run.
They'll use a lot of that clock. And there's the shot with three left, but it's missed by Burlowski. And Kidd rebounding. for Buckley, and Buckley never got the shot off. He's fouled by Nordgaard and may have got poked in the eye inadvertently.
Wisconsin Green Bay foul.
And this is what's going to happen for Cal if they can get the defensive rebound and go. You see Green Bay, Wisconsin getting back. And a little reach in by number 34, Ben Berlowski. You can see his vision. He just sees the whole court. And they want to run like that.
Berlowski's first foul. Buckley hits the first one. And the first two Cal points, 6-2. Wisconsin Green Bay leading with 14:56 remaining first half.
See Cal looking for a half-court trap right here.
And they show it on Berlowski, but he controls Nordgaard, however. Bothered by Kidd, topped it up. Jason Kidd for Buckley, and Berlowski, good job to break that up. Nordgaard stolen by Kidd. And Kidd comes up at the points. A foul is called on Berlowski, his second in less than a minute.
Jason Kidd, 93 steals on the year, 110 last year. He led the Pac-10 in single season record. But his defense is what makes things happen. Look, he's right there. You're going to see the ball inside and comes right behind with the steal. And then he comes down with another steal on the other end.
And the foul occurred before the shot, so it remains 6-2. Wisconsin Green Bay, California ball. Kidd inbounding. Murray outside. Anwar McQueen in the lineup, number 14. And again, Kidd hits after the whistle.
California personal foul, number 33, Achille Jones. His
Jones
personal foul.
Pick up a foul for the Golden Bears. The ball goes to Wisconsin Green Bay. Still 6-2. Anwar McQueen, a freshman from Washington, D.C., in the lineup for the Golden Bears with Jones, Kidd, Murray.
Green Bay possession.
Those long passes by Wisconsin Green Bay is going to catch up to them because Cal is a very quick team. They can step into that passing lane.
Nordgaard's turnaround is short. Covered by Lamon Murray. Kidd's bullet pass to Murray, and Murray trying the three, can't get it. Nordgaard rebounding.
Good boards by the Phoenix.
Resch to Martinez. And he hits from three. John Martinez averages 10.2 points a game, and he's got three here.
Cal right now a little frustrated, Tim, because they are having to play this half-court game. They need to loosen up a little bit, not run so much, but execute in their half-court game and run.
Buckley missing. And the Golden Bears, cool shooting as well. Berlowski rebounds.
And now that the Bears have to play defense, they have to play defense for at least 20 to 25 seconds, if not 30, because Green Bay was Wisconsin Green Bay. I don't know whether I should mix that up. I'll just say the Phoenix for now on.
Just call them Green Bay. Yeah, they're
Green
used
Bay
to that. Think of the pack. The Golden Bears 0-for-6 from the floor. They're only 2 points from the free throw line. Nordgaard inside. He's got it.
With 5 seconds left on the shot clock.
11-2. 6 points for Nordgaard. California still looking for a field goal. Seven and a half minutes gone. A little more than that now here in the first half.
What's happening with Cal in their offense right now, they're just going through the motion offense. They're not setting screens. Guys aren't coming off the picks and waiting for them to open themselves up.
McQueen, three-pointer missing. It'll be Phoenix ball.
Substitutions for California, number 52. Ryan Jameson at number 44.
Just very patient on offense. They don't get rattled.
Number 12.
Nice pass inside. Jeff Nordgaard going underneath to protect the ball.
Also into the Phoenix.
Nice little reverse shot.
Number 55.
And see, that's what's frustrating when you get a lot of great athletes. They're looking to run up and down the court. And even when you do play in the half-court game, not saying that Green Bay doesn't have good athletes. They do. but as far as executing, they're a lot more patient within their offense, and they don't get rattled when the shot clock is down to 30.
Michael Stewart back in for California. Eric Jackson, number 12, in for Wisconsin Green Bay.
That shot probably was a little too quick for them.
Foul called against Green Bay's Vandervelden.
Talked about the Bears not having that deep a bench.
Wisconsin Green Bay.
But also Green Bay cannot afford to get into foul trouble. Their key guys,
number 32, Logan Vandervelden,
have certain roles to play. And if they're on the bench, they're not going to help their teammates.
Logan Vandervelden, number 32, picked up the foul. He had just come in for the Phoenix. Kidd for McQueen. Jason Kidd, three-pointer is short. Jackson rebounding for Green Bay. In the corner, Vandervelden, yes, for two.
I think a lot of people are surprised right now the way things are going for Green Bay. A lot of them are happy, but the Bears, very
California
disappointed.
Still looking for their first field goal. Back here on the campus of Weber State in Ogden, Utah, Wisconsin, Green Bay, a 13-2 lead. And Jason Kidd and his teammates still looking for their first field goal. As you can see, Wisconsin, Green Bay, five assists, none for the Golden Bears. They have only scored 2 points from the line, and we have 11:28 to go in the half.
Cal a little surprised and a little frustrated. They need to be more patient in their half-court offense. Set some good picks. Don't take the first open shot. Make sure you're wide open, and there you see McQueen. Really kind of not a good shot selection.
Air ball grabbed by Berlowski. Berlowski and Jackson, Gresh. Vandervelden.
Where the frustration comes to, Tim, you're playing good, hard defense, and then all of a sudden there's McQueen's going to be called for a foul. Which adds to the frustration because now the clock is reset for 35 seconds. And your frustration is, hey, you want to get some points. You want to get going. You're having to play defense the whole time and nothing has happened for you. So they have to have something positive happen off a steal, off a defensive rebound, and then they have to convert.
McQueen picking up the foul for the Golden Bears. Phoenix possession. They've got Jeff Zavada in the lineup. Reserve center number 55, a senior from Stevens Point, Wisconsin. And Jackson hits. He is a 48% three-point shooter off the bench for the Phoenix, widening the lead 16-2. Murray missing. And the follow, finally the first field goal scored by Jamison, the center.
At 10:24 in the first half.
Phoenix substituting freely here, and the theory there on the part of Dick Bennett at this altitude particularly may be to try and wear down this undermanned Golden Bear team with fresh legs. The miss underneath from Gresh. Kidd rebounding, and Murray off the glass missing, got his own rebound, he's all tied up, and he is fouled.
Well, there's a penetration by Lamon Murray, he gets it from Jason Kidd past the three-point line, and yeah, he can take that jumper past the three-point, but to create an offense here off the missed shot by Gresh, which is a nice move underneath, they get it and go, but Kidd is going to pass to Lamon Murray coming from behind the three-point line, and look at him just penetrate. Great penetration there, and that's what Cal needs to get things moving.
Gresh picked up the foul as first. Murray deep in the corner. Kidd, Kidd's turnaround, and that's good for three. Jason Kidd's first points. 16-7 now. Nordgaard had to hustle the handle. Outside to LeDuc.
And the biggest thing for Green Bay is not to make mistakes. They have to take care of the basketball within this offense and not have turnovers. They want to get a shot off in their possession.
We've got a tall lineup in there right now, and that pass goes awry. McQueen travels coming out. LeDuc at 6'7", Ludvigson at 6'9", Nordgaard at 6'6". All in there together.
Well, you see Kidd posting up, and then he takes it beyond the three-point line, just squares up and fires it.
Fresh and Martinez, the backcourt for the Phoenix. This is Martinez. No basket, the foul before the shot.
No basket. Wisconsin Green Bay foul.
And Leduc.
Well, you know, in Green Bay, they don't call those screens, Tim. They call them blocks. They practice right across from where the Packers work out, Lambeau Field. And they decided we don't set screens, we set blocks.
Number three, Bonnie Buckley. Shooting one on the
line. Eric Leduc, the 6'7 senior, is setting a block. And you see Buckley trying to get over the top, and they call the offensive foul.
17 foul against the Phoenix. Buckley at the line missed the first of the 1-on-1. 16-7, the score remains. Martinez, another three-pointer.
The timing with Green Bay in their offense, they don't just run around a screen. They wait till a screen is set so the defense gets picked off. That's where a lot of teams throughout the country have trouble. They think they're running their offense, but they don't execute because they don't wait for the screens.
Queen and Kidd, the backcourt pair now for the Golden Bears. Kidd's pass inside intended for Murray. Goes off the hands of number 52.
Great hustle by Anwar McQueen.
It
is going to go to Green Bay, but it was a great hustle. And again, good defense by Gary Gresh. Once Jason Kidd got up into the air, he had to change his shot and look for the pass. Cal trying to extend their defense and trap.
Nordgaard. Follow. Nordgaard on his second try taps it in, 21-7. Wisconsin Green Bay, 7:59 to go first half. Number 12 seed in the West, an errant pass. Buckley started to break for the hoop. Kidd threw it behind him. 10 turnovers by California. We have 7:48 to go, and the upstart Wisconsin Green Bay Phoenix leads.
Cal has decided to press in a half-court trap, 2-2-1. And what's happening is Green Bay is coming right down the middle, because the rotation for Cal is not getting there. The Phoenix are a very good passing team, and you'll see it wide open down the lane because the rotation for Cal is not there, it's too slow. So we'll have to see if Cal stays in that press because of the kind of passing the Phoenix are able to do.
Ball goes off Martinez.
One of the few turnovers in this first half for Phoenix. A little bit out of control that time for Martinez.
Sixth turnover by the Phoenix. Queen remains at guard with Jason Kidd. And Kidd driving.
They count the basket. But Cal trying to create something off the penetration. Good move right there, going faking to the right. And Jason Kidd so adept with his left hand, kissing it off the glass, baseline wide open. And there you see also the Nordgaard defensively with his back to the player.
6 points for Kidd, 21-10, 11-point lead. Chris Westlake in the ball game for the Phoenix, a junior guard number 10 from Rockford, Illinois.
Now Cal picking up full court in a man-to-man. Which is a lot, it's a lot different in that trap because now they're trying to create pressure in the full court in bringing the ball up where they're making the passes a little bit more difficult and not as close to the basket.
Dick Bennett continuing to substitute freely. Logan Vandervellen back in. Westlake in for his first shift. Working the backcourt with Martinez. This is Westlake.
Well, you just really like the way the Phoenix use their screens, even though shots missed by Westlake there. Good penetration.
kid working the lane. Gets the shot up and won't drop for him, but he's fouled.
Wisconsin rebound foul, number 10, Chris Westlake.
Kid will go to the line, and we've commented on Dick Bennett using a lot of his bench early here, perhaps in an effort to wear down the undermanned California Golden Bears. Wisconsin has gone five deep already beyond their starters, and California really only has McQueen and Jones that they can use. After that, they're down to a couple of guys that don't normally see a lot of action except when necessary. Of course, that's due to the injuries to Grigson, Roberts, and Duck, all out of action.
And a great situation right here for Jason Kidd to be at the line. He wants to create things. Good free throw shooter. He has not been during the course of the season in conference, but when you put him in a pressure situation, he has really come through. But Dick Bennett, very upset with the way the calls are going right now. He wants his players to be able to play some kind of defense.
California pressing down court here. Phoenix bring it up. Martinez. Gresh using LeDuc's screen. Now back for LeDuc. And LeDuc trying to bounce pass. It went off the foot of Michael Stewart.
It really seems like the Bears have kind of picked up the intensity on defense, because you almost see it in the offense with Green Bay, and they don't have to lose their patience, which they have not done so far. But that series right there, they looked a little impatient because of the Bears' intensity on defense.
Still a 9-point lead for Wisconsin Green Bay. That's Vander Velden, a 3-pointer, a 6'9 senior. 5 points for him. Valders, Wisconsin.
Well, I tell you right now, Green Bay's got a lot of guys contributing offensively. You can't key in on one guy.
Well, they don't have the superstar of the kid style or anything approaching it, but they play totally as a team, and they have that kind of balance. Three players in double figures over the season, and then Livingston with an 8.3 average, and Burlowski, the three-point shooter, with a 7.5 average.
Tough break for Dick Bennett's team again. Eric LeDuc picking up his second personal, and this is what is going to kill Phoenix as far as getting into foul trouble. Michael Stewart made the All-Pac-10 freshman team this year, nicknamed Yogi.
Good nickname.
His older brother used to like the cartoon when
Yogi Bear
was growing up, and when Michael was a baby, he said, "Hey, you're going to be called Yogi," and it has stuck.
Holy smokes, Michael Stewart.
Kind of looked like it was a bear paw right there.
Holy boy, he wants to hide under his jersey after that shot. Little tournament jitters to the freshman, but he gets the second one. Michael Stewart. Let's go back and see what Michael thought when he missed it.
Oh, a little
oh yuck.
That's okay, I'll get it back.
24-13. Wisconsin Green Bay leading. Kidd checking Gresh closely. Gresh off to Ludvigsen. Martinez pumps once. Off the front iron, rebounded by Burlowski. Vander Velden won't go for him. Ludvigsen rebounding. Burlowski missing. Well, they did all of the offensive rebounding job. It came away with no points. Kid for Murray, and Murray can't drop it. And the Bears collide with each other. A push underneath.
Lamon Murray still held scoreless, but another foul called on the Phoenix.
Vander Velden second.
His second personal foul. Into the Wisconsin Green Bay lineup, number 55, Jeff Zavala.
Jamison, the center, goes to the line. Ryan Jamison, 6'11 junior from Los Angeles.
Jamison had a big game this year, 18 points against Cincinnati.
California's low for a half this season. 22 points against Kansas very early in the season. They have 15 now with 5:09 left to play. Vander Velden going to the hoop, and it's taken right out of his hands. job by Jamison. Kidd back the other way. Kidd for Jamison, and Jamison's turnaround is good.
Jamison defensively at 6'11", getting position and driving him down low. But look at Jason Kidd. He just hangs up in the air, sees everything as he's coming down, and Jamison was wide open and going to the free throw line.
Chance for a three-point play for Jamison. 7-point margin now. The Golden Bears chipping away at the early lead of the Phoenix of Green Bay. 10-2 run now for Cal. 7 points for Jamison. Over the last 3 minutes, the Golden Bears have turned it around.
And Green Bay has not been as patient on their offense.
Berlowski for three. No, well off. Rebound by Jamison.
The last three possessions have been quick shots.
Jason Kidd short. Picked off by Gresh. Nordgaard's hook is good. 10 points for Jeff Nordgaard, the sophomore from Dawson, Minnesota. Foul by Jamison.
Nordgaard, a nice little turnaround hook right there. Good control. Jamison with the body on the foul, but big bucket for Green Bay because, Tim, getting into a running game is not going to be to their advantage with Cal.
Nordgaard misses the back end of the three. Cal controls the rebound. 4:20 to go. 26-18. The number 12 seeded Wisconsin Green Bay Phoenix from the Mid-Continent Conference. There are some folks tuning in and never even heard of that conference. But they can play with a big boy. There's a hit from outside by Murray.
His first 2 points in 4 minutes left in the first half.
He averages 24.5 a game. 6'7 junior from Fremont. Berlowski, and he rushed again. Twice now, Berlowski is unloaded early.
Well, what happens, too, with Phoenix getting into a running game with the Bears, they've got to really hustle back quicker on defense, where before when they set up in their half court, they're making the Bears work hard.
Nice turnaround by Ryan Jamison. The junior now has 9. The margin is 4. Nordgaard, no. Bears rebound, Murray. Kidd driving hard, he misses the layup. Ludvigsen rebounded.
But that's okay, I think Cal wants that pace. Even though Jason Kidd misses a shot like that, it still keeps the tempo up.
Buckley pressing down court by himself. Gresh is knocked onto his backside by Murray, and Murray will pick up the penalty. The foul on the play to Murray, his first.
Timeout on the floor.
And we have a timeout with 2:51 remaining, a 5-point lead for the Phoenix. Tim Ryan with Ann Myers back here in Ogden, Utah. California did not score a field goal until 10-10 into this first half. They have battled back here now, and despite turning it over 10 times, trail by only 4 points, 2:49 to go. Cal has come from behind a 10-point deficit 3 times this year to win at Arizona, at home against Arizona State, and at Washington. So while they have struggled early, they have battled back to make it close here near the end of this half.
And those are 3 games that Lamon Murray struggled, did not score in double figures in any 3 of those games.
Murray, 1 for 7 from the field, just 2 points. Basket will not count. Second foul against Ryan Jamison. You can see the Phoenix has cooled off. They shot 54% in the first 10 minutes. The Bears were looking for their first basket since that time, 27% from the field. And as Ann has pointed out, they've simply not been as patient as they normally are under Dick Bennett's tutelage.
A lot of that has to do with Cal's defense is part of picking up the intensity, but with a patient offense, you've just got to take the leadership of the seniors out there. Nice pass.
That's more like it. That's their style.
44, Jeremy Ludvigsen.
Ludvigsen from Nordgaard. Sounds like the Scandinavian national team here.
I'm letting you say those. You, just getting back from Lillehammer, I'm letting you say those names.
Jeff Nordgaard would be Nordgaard over there. Martinez. And it goes for Martinez. Now the Phoenix crank it up again. 8 points for him, 30-22.
Clutch basket by John Martinez, a senior on this team. He missed 8 games early with a partial tear in that left knee. He decided to play the rest of the season with it.
Kid using Jamison. Works the baseline. Now his pass is gathered in by Murray and then knocked away. It's a freebie for Martinez. Look at Kid come back. Good play by Martinez to Ledoux.
I tell you, it's Phoenix fun to watch. Great fundamental basketball.
Boy, he didn't take Kidd for granted. He must have felt Kidd making that charge back to stop the easy layup.
Resch is just staying right in between Jason Kidd and the basket. He's not letting them go anywhere. I see Eric Ledoux going to pick up his third personal.
Wisconsin Green Bay Power, number 52.
But watch Martin Martinez knock it away all by himself. He sees Kidd. But watch, he's got his teammate Ledoux following behind him. That's good basketball teamwork, helping each other out.
Three fouls on Ledoux. He'll leave to be replaced by Vandervellen, Logan Vandervellen.
At the free throw line is Lamont Murray, shooting two.
Murray, a 77% free throw shooter, struggling in this game right now.
With only one field goal in the first half.
But he's been known to come back in the second halves.
California substitution number 3, Monty Buckley.
32-23. Buckley comes in for the Golden Bears. And Murray goes up. Martinez, Gresh, Berlowski, Vandervelden, and Ludvigsen. The lineup for the Phoenix, and this is Ludvigsen. Rebounded by Buckley.
Ludvigsen was wide open, but it's a quick shot by Phoenix. They need to take more time off the clock because they had all the clock going into halftime.
20 seconds left in the half. Kidd playing for the last shot. McQueen checking Todd Bozeman at the Golden Bear bench for the play. Kidd with the ball, running out of time.
Gresh just doesn't want him to penetrate.
And he tries for three, it won't go. After his own rebound, gets it up, and it is off the front iron as a buzzer sound. So Jason Kidd, 8 points, 2 assists. They didn't score a basket until 10 minutes into the game. And the Phoenix of Wisconsin Green Bay, the number 12 seed, leads the number 5 seeded California Golden Bears 32-23. Weber State in Ogden, Utah. I'm Tim Ryan with Ann Myers. There's the score at halftime, a 9-point lead for Wisconsin Green Bay. And for a report from what Todd Bozeman is thinking at this point, let's go to Jim Gray.
All right, thank you very much. Jim, Todd Bozeman's very upset because they're playing Green Bay, Wisconsin's pace. He said, we need to pick it up. We need to penetrate. The game is Jason Kidd's to take over. We've got to get him more involved, take better shots, be a little bit more patient, make the extra pass this half, and play a quicker transition game. Back over to you, Tim and Ann.
Okay, Jim. Well, you know, California is 0-2 when down by 9 or more at the half. They lost to Arizona and Kansas in that circumstance. All the other numbers are against them as well because Wisconsin Green Bay, third in the nation in scoring defense, holds teams to 54.7 points a game. Well, if you double the California output, they would have only 46. They also hold teams to 37% shooting from the field. California shooting at 25%.
And those are both number 3 in the country.
Kidd and company have to crank it up here in order to come from behind and avoid an upset to the number 12 seeded Wisconsin Green Bay Fighting Phoenix. Nordgaard's 12 points now as Green Bay opens the scoring in the second half.
Well, you definitely got to get Buckley and Murray involved in this game. keep the ball in kids' hands. And as Todd Bozeman was saying, Jim Gray was alluding to, you need to pick up the pace. It doesn't mean you need to take quick shots. You take a good shot selection, make that extra pass, make sure it's a good shot selection.
Jason Kidd, 8 points, 6 rebounds, 2 assists in the first half. Turned it over 3 times as well.
It's a team, Cal, that averages 18 assists a game, and there they turn it over.
Jamison lost it. He was the leading scorer for Cal in the first half.
Cal started to come back towards the end of that first half when they picked up pressure, man-to-man full court defense. But to keep it going in this altitude, and with not very much bench to help you out, it's very difficult.
Martinez to the corner for Nordgaard, and he hits for three. 14 points now for Jeff Nordgaard, the sophomore from Dawson, Minnesota. Kid in traffic, off for Murray. Murray missing. Resch rebound. Resch, Martinez, Ludvigsen, Nordgaard.
That shot Murray took was a little bit like Stewart's free throw in the first half. We've seen Murray throughout the course of the year, though, nail those down, but he obviously has not gotten into this game yet.
Ludvigsen, the senior from Edgewood, Iowa. 38-23, Todd Bozeman says, hold everything. Timeout, California. 18-18 to go in the second half.
CBS Sports' exclusive coverage of the first round of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Oldsmobile, AT&T, and by Midas.
Well, the Cheeseheads are happy here. That's the student band for the Phoenix of Wisconsin Green Bay.
And maybe a little bit of luck of the Irish right now, but you see the shots from the outside. But look at all the shots from the inside that Green Bay is getting against this Cal team. Cal, you would think, would be able to use their height a little bit more, but they cannot control Green Bay getting the ball inside.
California starting badly again here in the second half, and here's a freebie. Ludvigsen. California hasn't scored.
Great heads-up play by Berlowski, getting the ball down court. Actually, it was Nordgaard. Sorry.
17:46 remaining. And a foul called on Gresh as Kidd started his drive.
Number 22, Gary Gresh. His second personal foul. That's the first Wisconsin Green Bay.
Look at all the green jerseys down inside. And then all of a sudden, Ludvigsen takes off, and nobody for Cal able to get down and spot him.
Alley-oop for Murray. Nice play.
That's got to break the ice for Lamont Murray. He's got to get things rolling for Cal.
15-point lead for the Phoenix. Well, some of the coaching cognoscenti know what Dick Bennett is capable of with his good coaching of fundamentals. Our own Al McGuire commented on the telecast a couple of weeks ago that this team could do this. They could upset California in the first round. And they are in good shape right now.
Well, how simple, playing basic basketball. You get the ball down low, little pump fake, because today the players love to block shots. They go for any little fake. And you see Jeff Nordgaard going up for a little pump fake and continuing in it for the basket.
16 points for Nordgaard. Missing on the try for a third point. Kidd back the other way for the Golden Bears. Followed his own shot, won't go for him. Murray has the rebound. And Murray driving. The basket will count. He is fouled. LeDuc.
Big offensive rebound for Cal to keep things going. Jason Kidd getting frustrated a little, trying to create things. And here the ball just bounces back to Murray. Goes to the basket because he's not having any luck to the outside. And they call the block.
Fourth personal foul on Eric LeDuc, the senior. He gets a rest. Vandervelden is in for him. 42-27. Martinez back out for Ludvigsen. Off the mark, rebound, Kidd way up for that one.
Thing is right now for Kidd, he, in a sense, on the break, is looking for the shot because nobody's helping him out. Big bucket from Lamon Murray.
Murray just helped him. Lamon Murray now has 9. Remember, Murray averages 24.5 a game. Struggled in the first half. Martinez, Gresh. Martinez from 3-point range, yes. 11 points, Martinez. Murray traveling, trying to back his way in and at least draw a foul, picks up the travel.
Well, four green jerseys just holding their ground. And Murray trying to get things happen. Cal is looking to get the ball to Lamon Murray, trying to create something. He makes the pivot. And I don't know where they call the travel. It might have been before the move, but not afterwards.
Wisconsin lead by possession.
Jamison diving to knock the ball out.
Phoenix substitution.
Green Bay keeps the ball.
Number 12, Derek Jackson.
And Jackson comes in.
You talk a little bit about this pressure defense of Dick Bennett's. I was talking to him yesterday, and he was saying, I asked him, you know, who's kind of influenced you on your coaching? He said, well, a lot of early high school coaches, but Bobby Knight when he was at West Point, because of the way they play defense. And Green Bay does a lot of that they do at Indiana, just good, solid, fundamental defense and executing their offense.
Jackson in the backcourt now, number 12. Eric Jackson is a sophomore from Milwaukee. Feed inside for Nordgaard. Perfect pass from Ludvigsen. The Scandinavian connection. Wearing the green on St. Patrick's Day.
Cal at the 15-minute mark really need to pick up the pace, get things going, because otherwise a lot of people expecting to see Adrian Autry from Syracuse and Jason Kidd matched up. They're not going to get that opportunity.
Murray's hook won't go. Follow does.
Field goal by number 3, Monty Buckley.
Buckley got a hand on it. 47-31. Nordgaard. Bears rebound. Murray for Kidd. Kidd's 3-point try. And Ludvigsen will be charged with the foul as he was battling Ryan Jamison for the rebound.
One of the reasons that Green Bay is able to get wide open again, you see the screens, Cal is sagging back a little bit, can't get through the screens, and there you see, cutting from the top, Nordgaard getting an easy two.
Achille Jones.
Jones in the game for the Golden Bears. Kidd's alley-oop try for Buckley. Murray with a follow. He's fouled by Vanderbilt.
Wisconsin Green Bay foul. Number 44, Jeremy Ludvigsen. His third personal foul.
That is third on Ludvigsen, pardon me, pick up the foul. His third. Two in a row, so he'll get a rest. And that brings in Jeff Zavada, the senior center, 6'9 from Stevens Point, Wisconsin.
At the free throw line for California, number 21, Lamon.
Dick Bennett having to use a lot of guys on Lamon Murray, but I'm sure it's not what he really planned for because of the foul situation that they're in.
Murray gets one for 10, and he'll have another try, 47-32.
Mentioned that he had 2 points early in the season against Washington and came back and scored 20 in the second half.
Murray, a 77% free throw shooter, picks up a pair. 47-33 the score. Now the Bears pressing down court. Gresh with Kidd right on him. Nordgaard, Gresh outside.
Green Bay has done a very good job taking care of the basketball.
Jackson is fouled by Jones. Achille Jones a little too tight on him. His second personal.
Achille Jones, his second personal foul.
From last year's team, Achille Jones, a senior this year, was voted most improved player last year. He's not had a lot of minutes. You hear Cal, they're talking a lot more out there, more so than they did in the first half.
And they're checking closely now. Nevada underneath. Nevada can't get the shot away. And the Bears come up with a turnover. Murray. Ball still loose, and Martinez. 3-on-2. And a good play by Buckley to knock it away, but Wisconsin Green Bay will keep possession.
Well, it just seems everything that Green Bay is doing also, Tim, it's almost right. They're coming up with all the loose balls. Well, they're calling a very tight game as far as what happened in the first half. I know Dick Bennett was not pleased with some of the calls, but here Cal has been called for two fouls on the outside away from the basket.
Michael Stewart picked up that one. The officials are Leonard Wirtz, the referee from Mount Healthy, Ohio, Edward Corbett from Yonkers, New York, Rick Hartzell from Lewisburg, Pennsylvania. Nordgaard got loose but missed the shot. Rebound Stewart, Kidd with it.
Jason Kidd is coming down and you think, well, why, they're gonna call an offensive foul. How come they can't get down and score in that break situation? It's not a break situation because Green Bay is getting back on defense and not allowing Cal to really create anything in the open floor.
Buckley with a push off the ball, foul for California.
That's a 14th foul. Into the Wisconsin Green Bay lineup, number 44.
Berkeley Bears trailing 47-33. 14 foul on California, same as Wisconsin Green Bay at this point. 12 minutes, 15 seconds left, regulation time. Drop for Martinez, and another foul.
Jason Kidd's back.
His second personal foul.
Two against Nevada. All of the big men.
Wisconsin
Green Bay have at least two. Kidd penetrating in deep and drops it off the glass. 10 points. Kidd's feet are so quick he kind of sneaks in. Just working his way in as close as he can. Before you know it, he's there underneath. A steal, Buckley. And Buckley with a good effort, stealing from Vandervelden and making it pay. 10-point margin. 6 points for Buckley.
And see, you can feel the positive vibes from Cal. As far as a team, they've had two positive things happen, scoring the baskets, another turnover.
Gresh with a bad pass. Jones.
Bennett trying to call a timeout for his team. Three quick baskets by Cal puts him right back in it.
11-14 remains, 47-39. The Bears coming back on Wisconsin Green Bay.
Well, if the media had it their way, they already have me in the NBA, and that's kind of bad, but I want to come back, and I'll make my decision when the time comes after the Final Four, hopefully. But this isn't going to be my last tournament. I have 6 games here, and then I have a whole nother season with Cal, hopefully.
Well, that's Jason Kidd yesterday, and certainly the sense of that is that he's planning on being back with California.
Well, he wants to play baseball this season, too. He played in high school. He was an outfielder and a catcher, and he hit .333.
Todd Bozeman avoided discussion of the possibility of Kidd turning pro in yesterday's press conference here in Ogden. You can see Kidd in his interview with us indicating that he's thinking more about more NCAA tournaments before his entry into the NBA. And that is Gresh.
His first 2 points of the game.
49-39, and Dick Bennett, when he called that timeout, told his team, Jim Gray over there listening in, that, hey, guys, you're playing like you're panicking, like you're the team that's trailing. He said, you're ahead. No reason to play that way, like you're afraid to win this thing.
Also coming out of that timeout, Green Bay's got to do a little bit better job on the defensive boards, because Cal now has 12 offensive boards, and you're going to see Jones picking up the foul, but Cal has 12 offensive boards, and Green Bay holds their opponents to only 11 offensive boards.
Third personal on Achille Jones. Now remember, they have only two real substitutes. This undermanned California team, injury racked all season long, McQueen and Jones, both guards, and Jones with three fouls. Good hustle, Gresh. Martinez back the other way. And Martinez coughs it up with a bad pass. 4-on-2, California. Kits. And the basket missed, but the foul call. Murray missed it inside.
That was just great hustle by both teams.
Wisconsin Green Bay foul, number 22, Gresh.
Ball's knocked away. Good defense by Cal. Buckley trying to keep it alive. Gresh just staying on his feet. Stays after it, and then back down the other way. Martinez does not make a good pass, and Cal trying to come down, and maybe a little bit too unselfish, because Jason Kidd, once you're down there that low, you can't keep passing it.
Exactly my sentiments. That was one pass too many there. He was in position to shoot. Gresh picking up the foul on that play. Murray at the line. And he has 13 points now, 49. 41, the lead, Wisconsin Green Bay.
Close as they've been in a long time.
12 points for Murray in this half. Martinez won't go for him. Kidd up high to rebound. And Murray fouled at the baseline.
Well, in this game, if you reach in, you're going to get called for a foul. And
Gary Gresh
trying to cut off baseline against Lamon Murray as Murray's going up.
Putting California in the bonus.
You see Green Bay trying to get back on defense, and they do a good job of it.
Into the game,
here you see three green jerseys, and Lamon taking the baseline.
Green Bay, number 32,
four personals on Gresh. They'll have to take him out for a bit. 9:18 to go.
Shooting two.
Murray at the line again.
Shots, Murray, that nice shooter's touch. You can see the roll, the seams going to the basket. When you shoot the ball like that, it has a tendency to grab the rim a little bit better.
One of two for Murray, 14 points. Keely Jones, yes. Three-pointer.
And good penetration by Jason Kidd. What Cal needs to do is penetrate like that and then kick it back out to their outside shooters.
4 points, the margin now. The Golden Bears battling back against the upstart Phoenix.
Since that timeout that Dick Bennett called, Green Bay has only scored one basket.
Foul called along the baseline against Murray. Ludvigson driving the line.
That's the sixth team foul.
Sixth team foul against the Golden Bears, so possession will be Green Bay's.
Bennett calling the play number two.
Vander Velden outside to Ludvigson. Berlowski. Martinez. Won't drop for him. Battle for the rebound, and Kidd way up against the taller Ludvigson. Keely Jones. Vandervelden, and he's fouled by Kidd.
So Jason Kidd's only first foul, but he is so quick. He sneaks up behind you, knocks that ball away. Comes down, good penetration. Almost had the lane if he had stopped a little bit more to look at the basket, but Jones misses it. Good rebounds by Green Bay. And Kidd handing the ball to the official. But Jason Kidd is just so quick. You talk so much about his passing and how much he sees the floor. It's his defense that makes him an all-around player also. Rebounds, does everything.
Monty Buckley comes in for Michael Stewart. For the Golden Bears. McQueen is in at guard. Vandervelde, 6 points for him now. 8:25 to go. 50-45. Vandervelde trying to make it a 6-point lead. He cannot. Kidd rebounding. Murray. Over Vandervelde. 3 points.
That's basically how Lamon Murray scores. Guys in his face.
3-point margin, 50-47.
It's an easier shot for him.
Yes, I guess. He's been hot in the second half. Bolowski bothered by Kidd. 13 points for Murray here in the second half. Bolowski missed the reverse layup. It's rebounded by Murray. Kidd got it back off the hands of Martinez. And throws up a dandy. 12 points for Jason Kidd.
What a comeback.
50-49. Martinez, his bank won't go. Vandervelde rebounding. Hooked away by Kidd. That goes out of bounds. Green Bay ball. So with 7:15 to go, an 18-point lead is evaporated to one.
Gary Brush and number 52, Eric Ledoux.
Tim Ryan and Ann Myers on the campus of Weber State University in Ogden, Utah. And the California Golden Bears have clawed their way back from 18 down, 50-49 the score now. The Phoenix of Wisconsin Green Bay, the number 12 seed here in the West Region. Leading by just a point. And it's off California Golden Bear.
And Jason Kidd saying, who touched it?
Yeah. And you can see one for 11 from the field.
In the last 4 minutes, Cal has outscored Green Bay 10-3.
Vic Bennett has to get his team calmed down again and back with the ball in the bucket. Nordgaard won't go for him, and it's rebounded by Jones to Kidd. Kidd pulls up underneath McQueen. The freshman from Washington, D.C. has California in front by one. The number five seeds, 22-7 coming in, won three of their last four games, and having to struggle from behind. Nordgaard to Ludvigsen, he lost it. Kidd the other way. And he coughs it up to Martinez, anticipating that pass. 3-on-2. LeDuc, Ludvigsen foul by Jones.
Some two nifty guards out there looking for the passes on the break. Martinez really knew what Jason Kidd was going to do on that break because he went left and he had looked right. And Martinez anticipated very nicely, then came back and waited for his teammates to fill the lane.
Number 44.
Four fouls on Jones, and I want to tell you, Kidd is starting to show some wear and tear here. He is resting hands on knees there on the foul line.
I want to know how much longer those shorts are going to get.
But he has been up and down this floor at full tilt here in the second half on virtually every series. And he is showing some wear and tear. 6:11 to go. Remember the altitude here in Ogden, Utah, over 4,000 feet. Tied at 51. Kidd and McQueen, the backcourt for the Golden Bears. Jones with four fouls on him on the bench. Murray kept alive by McQueen.
Well, you got McQueen running the point, really, and what it'll do, it'll free up Jason Kidd when he goes down low.
Jason Kidd in this essentially seven-man roster, the exception of walk-on Dan Gura and reserve Ulatunji Dean. Kidd has had to go the distance here, and he has done so. In and out on the three-point try. Good effort by Stewart. Murray won't go for him, and Green Bay rebounds.
You can see a lot of those short shots are short because the legs are not quite there coming down to the stretch.
Shots are short and shorts are long.
I'm glad you can say it.
Resch. Inside and Nordgaard all tied up on a double team. Now the Phoenix moving the ball around as they did, using the screens in the first half, down to five on the shot clock. Resch will have to throw it up. He does, and he hits. Two points, Green Bay, 53-51.
Gary Gresh does not score a lot of points, averages 3.7 a game. He's hit two key buckets in this second half when they have needed the basket right at the 35-second clock.
Murray working inside. Nice play, Lamon Murray. 18 points, 14 of them here in the second half for Murray. Martinez for three. Won't go. Murray rebounds. Jason Kidd. Buckley. California by two. 8 points for Buckley.
Wow, what a pass. You almost think that he's out of control, and all of a sudden, somebody's right there.
.319 to go, and it's Nordgaard.
Good heads-up play by Nordgaard. He knew that Jason Kidd was on him, and he posted down low, asking for that basketball.
20 points for Nordgaard, tied at 55. Wisconsin Green Bay led this game by 18. California didn't score a field goal in the first half until after the 10-minute mark, and here we are, under 3 minutes to go and tie. Murray's been the main man. In and out. McQueen. Push. Foul. Ludvigsen.
Wisconsin Green Bay foul. Number 44, Jeremy Ludvigsen.
Dick Bennett was down on the floor on all fours, yelling at his team. On defense. Move on defense. And then scream out. Before he comes out any farther.
That's a great picture of Dick Bennett, who doesn't look in repose like he would be out there banging the hardwood, but he's doing it. Of course, he's seeing an 18-point lead go against the number five seed in the West. And it is McQueen with a chance to put the Bears in front. He does.
Well, McQueen and Jones have come into this game for the Bears. We talked about their subs and definitely have helped Cal in this second half. Kind of let off a little bit of load. McQueen at the point, handling the ball, taking the pressure off Jason Kidd a little bit, and also Jones hitting some outside shots.
Foul was changed to Martinez, we're told, so there are only three fouls on Ludvigsen of Green Bay. A one-point margin, and underneath is Nordgaard. 22 points on a good feed. 22 points for Nordgaard. Green Bay by one. Murray, in and out. Stewart rebounding. He's fouled, and let's see, it could be either Ludvigsen or Vandervelde.
Wisconsin Green Bay foul, number 44, Jeremy Ludvigsen.
Now he's got four.
On Ludvigsen, that is his
fifth. It is Ludvigsen. Four on him.
Correction, that is his fourth personal foul.
Well, Dick Bennett was making sure because it was announced that it was his fifth. And
right, well, that was because of the one they changed just previously.
You caught it.
Well, our good statistician, Dick Bossing, passed that on to us immediately. They changed it after they had signaled it on Ludvigsen, the one previous to this one. That's what this discussion is about.
At the free throw line for California is Michael Stewart.
Stewart is at the line, and as we understand it to be so, it is four fouls now on Ludvigsen.
Ready, Nordgaard!
Stewart shoots two.
Stewart will shoot two, a one-point margin. He can send the Bears back in front. Gresh, LeDuc, and Ludvigsen, each with four.
Jim Gray came over and said that they just forgot to tell a PA guy.
Well, there's enough excitement here for things like that to happen. 2:07 to go as Stewart misses the first. And hits the second, the freshman from Sacramento. And we have 2:07 to go, tied at 57 here in Ogden. Well, it's been Lamon Murray scoring here with the help of Jason Kidd, setting him up frequently. 18 points, 14 of those in the second half. California with 17 offensive rebounds, and they have taken over the boards again here in the second half. It has been their comeback, 18 points down, and they are now tied at 57. 2 minutes to go. Tim Ryan and Ann Myers here in Ogden. The number 5-seeded California Golden Bears having to battle back against this somewhat unknown team from Wisconsin, Green Bay. Dick Bennett's squad on the Mid-Continent Conference tourney, and were considered by insiders as a possible upsetter here in Ogden.
Al McGuire knew.
And the turnover, a costly one. Kidd slows it down, 130 and under.
Cal's defense has really created their offense, has gotten them back into this game. Also their offensive rebounding. They've got 11 rebounds offensive in the second half.
California overcame a 20-point deficit against Arizona State back in February. That was early in the first half. They were down 34 to 14. Came back to win that game. Vanderbilt battles for the ball.
What a heads-up play.
He comes up with it, and they take the timeout immediately.
LeDuc,
103.
Bozeman wants the tie-up for the jump ball. But Eric LeDuc is calling timeout as soon as he hits, kind of a forced pass right into there to the middle. But LeDuc is calling timeout. And they wanted a jump ball, Cal did.
And it is LeDuc, not Vanderbilt. A good job by him. We'll be back. Ryan and Ann Myers in Ogden. It will be California ball. They had the arrow when LeDuc came up with the loose ball to get the timeout for Green Bay.
Green Bay got to take care of the basketball, keep it in the hands of Martinez, have him get a shot, or else Jeff Nordgaard. But just run your offense. Set your screens, look for the good open shot.
Let me correct that. Possession arrow was Green Bay's as LeDuc grabbed it.
Cal has to play solid defense. Not foul.
Under 40 seconds we go. It's knocked out of bounds on the hands of Murray. Green Bay still with possession. 37.8 left.
And 10 seconds left on the shot clock.
Martinez for Nordgaard. Nordgaard's been the hot man. He hits. 24 points for Nordgaard. And McQueen gets timeout for the California Golden Bears, 27.2 remaining to play. We'll be back at Ogden, Utah for the conclusion of this one in a moment. 59-57, the Phoenix on top of the Golden Bears. Remember, they led by 18. California battling back. We'll be right back.
gonna set something up defensively for.
All right, and we've got 27.2 seconds left to play here with Green Bay up by two. What's the next move?
Well, you can't have hindsight, but I really think that Cal made a mistake when they had that steal the last two possessions when Jason Kidd stole it and they walked it up and wasted time off the clock. I thought they should have kept attacking. They did not get any kind of shot off at all. Now they got to come out, 27 seconds left. You can't take a quick shot, but you got to take a shot within the course of at least 10 seconds to give yourself time enough that in case Green Bay plays good defense or they get the rebound, that you've got time enough to come back down and get another possession.
Well, Dick Bennett's team right now has given up 57 points. They average 54.7 over the season, and they are a very solid team defensively. The Golden Bears have been in this situation before when it's been decided by five or less. In the 2 years under Todd Bozeman, they have won nine and lost one, but they're down by two here, 27.2 remaining in regulation time. Let's show you that play that Ann was referring to.
Well, Jason Kidd just does a great job defensively posting up, and he's such a good defensive player, whether he's on the outside, on the perimeter, or whether he's down low. Then they walk it up. They've got a chance to push it up and save time on the clock. And here they don't, and within this course of possession, they don't even get a shot off. And there's Jason Kidd's parents.
California ball, McQueen.
Can't waste too much time.
Kidd. Kidd's got a shot. In and out. 14.8.
Now look for Cal to foul quickly. Not waste time.
Resch will inbound it. Martinez. And he's fouled. Five on Jones, Akili Jones, off the bench. Picks up his fifth foul. That'll bring Michael Stewart back.
Martinez, a 75% free throw shooter, hasn't been at the line in today's game. But he's been a clutch player for him.
The senior from Milwaukee has been one of the most poised players out there through the entire game for Dick Bennett. I think he personifies the kind of attitude that Bennett likes to have out there on the floor. He shot the ball well. He averages 10-2 a game. More poise from Martinez. To 57. The clock shows 61-9. Green Bay would love to have this margin, but it is 61-57 on our CBS scoreboard, and they are trying to repair the scoreboard here.
Dick Bennett telling his team to just come back down, Tim, and if they're going to take that three-point shot, back off. Don't foul them.
Stewart will inbound it. Kidd will handle it. Resch backs up with him. Kidd drives down the lane and missed it. Knocked out of bounds. Should be California ball. It is.
Well, Dick Bennett sure knew that drive was coming because he wanted his team to just collapse in that middle. 6 seconds.
Murray. Rebound. Upset. Fighting Phoenix wearing the green on St. Patrick's Day. And they hung in there after losing an 18-point lead to tie at 57-all. They scored the final 4 points and upset the number 5-seeded Golden Bears of California. And they are now 27-6 on the season. And their veteran coach, Dick Bennett, got him calmed down when he needed it most at the end for a 4-point win over California. And they'll next meet Syracuse. Let's go to Pat O'Brien in New York. We're here with the winning coach, Dick Bennett, and one of his outstanding players today, the senior John Martinez. John had 13.7 assists and 6 steals and represented the kind of poise that his coach likes to have out there. John, the poise at 18 points is not always as easy as it should be, right?
Yeah, it was real hard for me. I've had knee problems the last couple years, and I knew that Cal was an up-and-down team, and we knew that if they got running on us, we wouldn't have a chance, and that we had to slow the tempo down. And when we slow the tempo down, that gives not only me a chance, but our whole team a chance to get the shots we want.
Well, that 18-point lead evaporated very quickly, Coach Dick Bennett. In fact, we had a picture of you with that 18-point lead disappearing. You were literally beating on the hardwood.
Well, their ability to make runs is what had concerned us coming in. And we just, you know, we wanted the kids to be aggressive. We didn't want to go into a shell. So you walk that fine line between should we be trying this or should we be pulling it out? And quite frankly, I didn't know what to do besides beat on the floor.
Well, now you've got, I know you haven't had time to think about it. You're going to play Syracuse next, but you played in the Alaska shootout. How much did that help you to play the teams that, in there in the last shootout?
I think that probably was the most important thing we did early on, because at our level you're never sure. You know you can play well, but you're never sure if you can play well against the good people. And I think in that tournament we realized, hey, we can play if it's our kind of game. And for the most part today it was.
Well, for today, and hopefully it'll be there Saturday too.
Thank you.
Great job by Wisconsin Green Bay's Phoenix as they have scored an upset over California. Next meet Syracuse. Congratulations.
Thank you.